दोस्तों, होप यू ऑल आर एंजॉयिंग। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। हमने पढ़ा कि कार्बन कंपाउंड्स क्या होते हैं, ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स क्या होते हैं। अब हम देख रहे हैं कि ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स में कौन कौन सी क्लासेस होती हैं, कितने डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड होते हैं। आपको पता है कि कार्बन की सेल्फ लिंकिंग प्रॉपर्टी की वजह से सबसे ज्यादा ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स फॉर्म होते हैं, और उस प्रॉपर्टी को क्या कहते हैं? कैटिनेशन। कैटिनेशन, वी ऑल नो दैट ऑल द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स आर मेड अप ऑफ कार्बन एंड हाइड्रोजन, कंबाइनली दे कॉल्ड हाइड्रोकार्बन। एंड द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कार्बन बाय विच दे एनी कार्बन कंबाइंड विद अदर कार्बन बाय कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड इज नोन एज कैटिनेशन। नाउ ड्यू टू कैटिनेशन देयर आर क्लासेस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स। In general, I divide it into two organic types of classification. The first one is open chain compounds, and the second is cyclic compounds. And depending on the chain formation के हिसाब से जो organic compounds हैं वो दो तरीके के होते हैं। पहला होता है ओपन चेन कंपाउंड, दूसरा होता है साइक्लिक कंपाउंड। ओपन चेन कंपाउंड का मतलब हुआ कि जब कार्बन कार्बन के साथ एक लॉन्ग चेन बनाता है, ठीक ना, लॉन्ग चेन बनाता है और कहीं भी जाकर के वो एक लूप नहीं बनाता, मतलब क्लोज लूप नहीं फॉर्म करता, तो उसे हम ओपन चेन कंपाउंड कहते हैं। ओपन चेन कंपाउंड अगर हम सैचुरेटेड, पहले हम सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन को देखेंगे। सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन आर दोस कार्बन इन विच the carbon is bonded with another carbon by a single bond. When single bond is present, it's called saturated hydrocarbon. Saturated hydrocarbon को हम क्या कहते हैं? हम कहते हैं alkanes. Saturated hydrocarbons are also called alkanes. And the difference between two constitutive compounds, depending on n is number of carbon, and the difference between two constitutive compound is CH2. Single variation between two carbons, like n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it will take first 5 carbon compounds, and the formula of alkane in general is CnH2n+2. We studied this earlier. Now we are going to implement, when Cn is equal to 1, the C1H4 is called CH4, and the name for this compound is methane. Ane is representing alkane and meth is for one carbon. Similarly, for n is equal to 2, it is C2H6, and it is called ethane. N is equal to 3, C3H8, it is called propane. N is equal to 4, then C4H10 by this formula, and it is called butane. N is equal to 5, C5H12, and it is called pentane. Now, if you see the structure, of these molecular formula, like for CH4, one carbon is connected with 4 hydrogen. As the valency of carbon is tetravalent in nature, so carbon contains 4 hydrogen, carbon forms 4 covalent bonds with individual hydrogens to complete its octet. Similarly, for ethane, it is C2H6. Here, one bond is shared between carbon, and this is the single bond. So, it is a saturated hydrocarbon, and the chain is not looped. There is no connection between the outermost carbons. So, there is C2H6, where two carbon is combined to form ethane. Now, for propane, if we take, it is C3H8. Similarly, for butane and pentane too. Like if I draw for propane, C1, 2, 3, and number of hydrogen depending on number of free electrons. Like if we see in this, the first carbon is directly connected to another carbon, so one bond is between carbon and carbon. And how many electrons are free now for first carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4. Out of 4 electrons, one carbon, one electron is bonded with another carbon atom. So the rest 3 will be connected to hydrogen and they form CH3 single bond. In the second carbon, we see one bond is between first carbon and second carbon, and another bond is between second and third carbon. So it's already occupied 2 electrons. Now it has 2 more free electrons, which is going to be combined with hydrogen. So 2 hydrogens are only connected on second carbon. And similarly, as first, this third carbon is also having single bond between second carbon, and rest the 3 bonds are with hydrogen. So this forms C3H8 propane. Similarly for butane and pentane. In open chain system for saturated hydrocarbon, when we are increasing the number of carbons, there is one more property called branch chain. For open chain, there are 2 things. One is straight chain combination, straight chain compound, and another is branched chain compound. Now, how this branch chain be formed? Branch chain means it is like a additional carbon is attached not in the streamline, not in the main line of carbon series, but in the branch section, in the what we call supported section of the long chain of carbon. So branch chain is formed due to a property known as isomerism. I will explain this in later next video. I'll explain what is isomerism, but here we just want to discuss what is the branch chain system. Like for carbon, more than when n is equal to 4, or when we have more than 3 carbons, then there is a possibility of branch chain, and the molecular formula for both of them is same, but their structural formula and chemical properties varies according to the compound or structure. So for n is equal to 4, the compound is C4H10 in alkanes. Now we draw the structure 1, 2, 3, 4, starting from the first carbon. This is 4 carbons combined in a long chain, straight chain. Now we draw hydrogen to complete the compound configuration. Here 10 hydrogens are combined, 10 hydrogens are attached with individual carbons to form C4H10, and the formula is called butane. Now if we see that how the branch chain occurs, in this there are straight chain, but the isomer of this compound contains a branched carbon, a carbon in a branch replacing hydrogen from the place. Then the counting is starting from the least, C1, 2, 3, and the branch is same. Now this branch also contains 3 hydrogen, and here 1 hydrogen, and here 3 hydrogen. So if we count the number of carbon, here is 4, and number of hydrogen is 10. So it is similar to butane, but this is called a structural difference, between two compounds, and the name of this compound is depending on the position of carbon. So now here the branch chain carbon is combined at carbon number 2. So it is 2, and the compound which is formed by branch is methyl. It's not methane, it is methyl. When there is a deficiency of one hydrogen and a bond formation or a free bond is formed, it is called methyl. So it is 2-methyl prop. Why prop? Because in a straight chain there is only 3 carbon, 1, 2, 3. And for 3 carbon we use prop and ane because all the bonds are single. So this is an isomer, structural isomer of butane, C4H10. One is butane and another is 2-methyl propane. Similarly, if we take 5 carbons in a row, then we got 3 isomers of the compound, like C5H12. Here the first one is a straight chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 5 carbon attached with 12 hydrogen to complete the compound. Now this is the first one, and the name of this compound is, for 5 carbon we use pent and single bond, so it is pentane. Now another branch system by which we can get branch compound, if we take 1, 2, 3, 4 and a carbon in the branch. Similarly, okay, we can write this formula also by combination format, CH3 single bond CH2 single bond CH2 single bond CH2 CH3. You can write this as CH3. You can write this as CH2 CH2 CH2, and again CH3. So we can write this as this for molecular formula. Now we will take, when 4 carbons in a straight chain and 1 carbon in branch, now we will count the carbon in straight chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, and again the hydrogen CH3 CH2 CH CH3 CH3. Why here is CH rather than CH2? Because one more branch is formed and the one more hydrogen is replaced by methyl. So if we name it, it is okay. One more thing, for branch chains, or whenever we have a different molecule added in the system, the counting is started from the nearest carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is 2-methyl, what will be, the carbon is 4, so butane. 2-methyl butane is the compound formed when one branched methyl is organized at carbon number 2. Now if we take another isomer of this, when 3 carbons are combined and 2 carbons are in branch at carbon number 2, this is the formula, CH3 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 CH3. Here also the counting of carbon and hydrogen is fixed, C5H12. Now how this will be nominated, how you can name this compound, कैसे हम इस compound का नाम लेंगे? इसमें क्या है, एक chain के अंदर 3 carbon है, 1, 2, 3, और second carbon के अंदर के साथ 2 branched methyl है. CH3 stand for methyl, so the name of this compound is 2,2-dimethyl. And how many compounds carbon is there in a chain? 3. So 2,2-dimethyl propane. ठीक है, तो इस तरह हमने पता किया कि पेंटेन के दो और आइसोमर्स बन सकते हैं, 2-methyl butane एंड 2,2-dimethyl propane. ये तो बात हो गई सैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स की, लेकिन यही ब्रांच सिस्टम आपके अनसैचुरेटेड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स में भी होता है. फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू टेक, लेकिन क्या चाहिए सबसे पहली चीज ब्रांच सिस्टम के लिए, द नंबर ऑफ कार्बन इन अ कंपाउंड इज ऑलवेज ग्रेटर देन 4. इफ कार्बन इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू 4, इफ नंबर ऑफ कार्बन इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू 4 इन एन कंपाउंड, इट कैन फॉर्म ब्रांच सिस्टम. लाइक फॉर इफ यू टेक If we take but1ene for 4 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, and if we name one of the bond is double bond, so it is an alkene. What it is? Alkene. And the structural formula or generalized formula for alkene is CnH2n, where n represents the number of carbon. Now number of carbon is 4, so the compound is C4H8. If we see H3, only 2 bonds, there is only 1 bond free, and here only 2 hydrogen can be attached. So the compound is CH3, CH2, CH double bond, CH2. This is your compound for alkene. Now if we have a branch system, if we have the name of this compound is but, because 4 carbon plus 1 for the position of double bond, and ene for unsaturated double bond. So but1ene is the compound formed by 4 carbons in unsaturated hydrocarbon. But if we see the branching of this system, if we connect a CH3 by replacing this hydrogen or replacing this hydrogen, 1, 2, 3, and double bond CH2. अगर हम यहां कैलकुलेट करें तो नंबर ऑफ काउंटिंग ऑफ कार्बन इज 4 एंड काउंटिंग ऑफ हाइड्रोजन इज 8. सो बाय फॉर्मूला इट इज ऑल्सो अ ब्यूटीन, बट बाय स्ट्रक्चर हेयर 1, 2, 3. 3 कार्बन इन अ स्ट्रेट चेन, एंड एट विच पॉइंट यू आर गेटिंग डबल बॉन्ड, इट इज 1. एंड एट विच पॉइंट यू आर गेटिंग अ मिथाइल इज कार्बन नंबर 2. सो द नॉमिक्लेचर इज 2 methyl prop for 3 carbon and 1 ene. It is called 2 methyl prop 1 ene, and this is an isomer of butene. So finally we will get how the open chain compounds are distinguished and nomenclated in a system. In next video we will study about isomerism, and also we will study about cyclic compounds, how the cyclic compounds are formed and how we will name it in different ways. Thank you for watching this video. Hope you enjoy it.